सब्सक्राइब करिए शॉर्ट एंड डिक्टेशन चैनल को और दबाइए इस बेल आइकन को ताकि आपको मिले लेटेस्ट अपडेट्स।
बी रेडी, 5 सेकेंड्स, स्टार्ट। मिस्टर वाइस चेयरमैन सर, आई एम इंडीड ग्रेटफुल टू द हाउस फॉर देयर कंस्ट्रक्टिव कोऑपरेटिव एंड क्रिएटिव अप्रोच and particularly for lifting the whole debate without in any way bringing in party politics in so far as the export import aspect of the commerce ministry is concerned. It has been treated to be very much vital for the national economy, and naturally I do treat the various suggestions that have been put forward including the criticisms as a healthy sign. I have no doubt that these suggestions will help me in further improving the working of my ministry. Sir, certain issues have been made out by the honorable speakers, and particularly these questions have been put to me. What is the exact strategy of the government? How does the government look at the whole commerce ministry, at the export trade and the import trade? It is in this context that I felt that I should spell out the policies in a very precise form, and the House will please bear with me if I read to the extent a part of my speech, and afterwards I shall take up the suggestions from the honorable members. Sir, Ministry of Commerce has a very important role to play in the economy of the country. The export production efforts, the import and export policies, our attitude to the international trade policy matters are integral components of the government's overall development strategy of promoting growth with social justice. It goes without saying that to perform its task effectively, the Ministry of Commerce and the organizations and agencies under it, as also its representatives abroad, form a well-known group manned by honest, sincere and dedicated persons. Soon after I took charge of this ministry, I had to take urgent measures to cleanse and reorganize the ministry. Those persons about whom there were reasons to believe that they please the consideration of themselves or other individuals above the interests of the country had to be relieved of their responsibilities, and steps have been taken to find suitable replacements. The internal working of the ministry has also been restructured with a view to increasing its efficiency. I am also presently engaged in the task of examining ways and means of strengthening our commercial representation abroad so far as to serve our trade interests better. Sir, I suppose this was a good policy which was also appreciated by the honorable members. Sir, let me take this opportunity to outline the basic thrust of policies which derive their logic from the government's commitment to achieve full employment of our precious human resource as rapidly as possible and to accelerate our progress in the path towards economic self-reliance. With our new priorities, in order to meet the necessary import needs of our growing economy, we reiterate our commitment to the goal of rapid export expansion. As honorable members are aware, for the current year, our export target is placed at ₹15,700 crores, amounting to a growth rate of our export as high as 12 to 13%. Sir, the basic element of our new approaches are to shift our export mix towards the dynamic exports. These dynamic exports will be the leading sector of export expansion. These leading sectors are the ones in which we have long-term competitive advantage and whose export growth can be sustained without the help of long-term artificial crutches. These leading sectors of export expansion are engineering goods, ready-made garments, leather manufacturers, handicrafts, and technology-intensive products. Example, exports of consultancy and engineering services and project exports. The second element of our new export strategy for our traditional exports is to increase their productivity and to diversify the commodity mix so that we maximize domestic value added in these traditional exports. For instance, we are shifting away from our exports of law, hides and skins to finished leather and leather manufacturers. We will be exporting progressively large amounts of packet and bagged tea rather than bulk tea. Similarly, we will be increasing domestic value added in the exports of renewable natural resources, that is marine products, forestry products, etc., or depletable resources like ores and minerals. Third element of our export strategy is to minimize social costs of our exports by regulating the exports of essential mass consumption items. In case of items such as oil seeds, pulses, tea, vegetables, onions, etc., domestic requirements will always take precedence over the exports, and export efforts will not be allowed to have adverse effect on domestic availability or price. That does not mean that we shall not export. Here the question is one of safeguarding the interests of the producers and also of the consumers, and ultimately it is a question of safeguarding the interest of our country. However, I must underline that in many times we may have to restrain domestic consumption to fulfill our export commitments. Such a sacrifice, if at all it can be called as sacrifice, should not be looked upon with any undue concern.